With the penalty coming down for the four team and now him losing his shot to go to Miami via that win over in Texas, what was your reaction when you heard this come down today?
My reaction is exactly the same as it always is, that it's a black eye for the sport. It's a bad day for NASCAR. There's absolutely nothing good about this. And yet again, intentionally or not, we end up painted as the sport where everybody cheats and nobody cares.
So what do you do?
Well, I guess we do one of two things. We either just throw up our hands and say, stretching the rules, pushing the envelope. We can call it anything we want. We can add any semantics to it we want. That it's always been a part of the sport and it always will. Or we continue to go in the direction NASCAR's gone lately, and that's continue to escalate these penalties until conduct improves. And the 40-point penalty today was the maximum that NASCAR is allowed to invoke. Maybe they need to change the rules so 50 or 60 or 70 comes on the board next time. I don't know.
Okay, so I'm wondering, how do you think Kevin Harvick and his four team, how do you think they're going to respond when they show up at Phoenix to this?
Oh, I think they're going to show up at Phoenix with a chip on their shoulder and a bad attitude and ready to go out there and kick butts and take names again at ISM Speedway. And I still think that they'll be the favorites to do exactly that. The problem is, from their perspective, Shannon, is they're just one loose wheel, one pit road speeding penalty, one cut tire away from blowing this entire season out of the water and not making it to Homestead.
What are the fans saying about all this that came down today?
You know, it's just such old hat now. And what I hear from the fan base today is a lot of frustration, saying we don't like this. We're tired of it. We need it to stop. You know, they're not at all happy about the fact that it takes 3 days to get these decisions. They'd love to have a way to have this stuff get figured out on Sunday night before they load it up to go home. And I think that's doable, personally. So there's a lot of frustration out there right now in the fan base that what you thought you saw on Sunday was not even remotely what ended up being true.
I think there are so many scenarios now when you look at what could potentially happen at Phoenix and who could be racing for a championship in Miami. Who do you think benefits most from this news?
Well, all of those guys below the cut line obviously do, because they're at least somewhat closer to the promised land than they were a day ago. So, the big loser is obviously Kevin Harvick. The big winner is everybody below that cut line that now have a better opportunity to try and make up ground. And I guess Martin Truex Jr. is probably feeling a little better about life right now, too, because he's further above the cut line and he's not the number one guy in jeopardy anymore.
The loss of Rodney Childers, how do you think that's going to affect this team?
Huge. Huge. Rodney Childers and Cheddar Smith are one of the best crew chief, car chief combinations in the sport. The communication will not be the same. The decision making will not be the same. Tony Gibson is a great crew chief and he'll do just fine, but it's not the same as having your guy.
Thank you, Dave. You know, one thing, if they do get the victory with Gibson on top of that pit box, it could be exciting, at least watching him celebrate that victory as we saw him do at Daytona 500. Thank you so much. We'll talk to you next week.
Thank you, Shannon.